Some shit out. You know, the kid is in the building, the kid is here, and they don't have me in the junior heavyweight title reign. Yeah, what not? The fuck is going on in this goddamn business?
Why not? You can qualify.
This fucking place has got me fucking irate. Now, the kid always finds a way to get himself on the tape. Because if you don't want me for the junior heavyweights, fuck, I'll just do what the fuck I want. I'll conduct some interviews. So, cheers then.
How you doing, bud?
Hey, I'm alright, but okay, maybe
fuck the marks.
So anyway, so what do you think about the gimmick tonight?
I gotta wrestle some guy, Fuvitu Guerrero.
No.
El Dandy. I don't know, some guy who was somewhere and now he's coming here to face the best, whatever. I don't know, and they brought some other guy from Japan who won by a cunt hair against me in Japan, and that's Winger, who I'm shooting for.
This Winger, that's all. Didn't he get his face crushed?
Yeah, by Rick Wade, who I defeated many a times, like I did everyone else here, you know.
Alright, cool. Well, thank you very much for your time, guys.
Hey, no problem. You are
good. Good luck today.
that can handle this. Freak shit, I'm a rich enough poltergeist. Blessed with a heart, but it's cold as ice. It broke me twice. Now I walk with an axe, dressed in all jet black with contacts. Straight maniac, warlock, Sam Hain of Salem's Lot. Sam through the hourglass, ticking of the clock.
If you don't know by now, it's too late. We the most serious thugs on the market since they play. We the dead, we don't explain the field play. Berserko, keep it underground to maintain. Bitch, you better check us. I'm doing people even 66 for 6 months. Riding the dick that hurts with ghost folks. Pumping on a two-ton block with air folks. And it's like that. Ask for the run, we don't die.
Serial killers,
we don't die. Freaks of the night, we don't die.
We get high,
we don't die. Pulling up out of the ground, from the underground trouble I dug to keep away from the mainstream love. I just want somebody to move and get hurt. Got your whole dug deep in the dirt. Can't hurt with you bitch motherfuckers making love to the flesh. With a bitch name tatted on your chest. Me and motherfucking Matchbox, haunt the joint, bringing death to the people that don't get the money. We don't die.
Just like a $7 bill, voice my opinion regardless of how you feel. Free shit, it ain't about being rich. It's about juggalos and running with lunatics. As long as y'all rock this, we won't quit. We do it all for y'all, I mean that shit. Every one of y'all means everything to me. We bleed for y'all, that's why we call it family.
As for us, we don't die.
Serial killers,
we don't die. Freaks of the night, we don't die.
We get high,
we don't die.
The element of my self-inflicted pain. We're not positive and uplifted. Fuck you. Walk a mile in our shoes. Experience hard times and paying hell in dues. Freak shit. What I live, what I breathe. Cast out new next like he's diseased. Still they try to ban the sound. Cause supposedly it be resurrecting the dead from under hollow ground.
You in the dead zone. 10 points for us. You smell a cigarette smoke right before your lunch bust. You can't trust them, but I can bust them in half and sit back and laugh at all the shit I did. Can you do that? Did you school that? Better yet, I'm the wigged out serial killer, type to a vet. Freak show, different than the rest, but I love it so, put it to the test.
To take his time to avoid what's coming, and that's an ass whipping.
Of course he is, because he's not a physical athlete like Nassauer is. He likes to play the mind games like you said, 3D.
Don't get me wrong. He's a dangerous man, but his talent, there you go. One for you.
One for the road, you fucking asshole.
Sit and spin, homo.
But you see the mind games he's playing. He's extending a hand in friendship. Nobody wants to be your friend, you fucking pedophiler. Nizawa's going for it. What are you doing, Nizawa?
Watch it, Nizawa. He's a sneaky bastard.
Where could he went? It's so small. Where'd he go? What the fuck? Oh, Pearl Harbor. Jeez, old Pete. And look at him. He's loving it. He's fucking loving it.
Well, Acid's a dirty bastard. As I was saying before, he's a dangerous wrestler because he relies on shitty-ass, dirty tactics.
And choking people. What the fuck is this? It's not
and humping their neck. Look at that.
JCW or not, no legalness to that choke whatsoever. That fucking dick, he's getting me pissed off. And look, he's getting pissed off. The Juggalos are pumping me up. I hope they do the same for Nizawa.
Nizawa is a competitor known for 10-star matches. Look
there
at
you
this.
Go. You see it going down right now. Oh, the baseball slide. Oh!
Lightning speed. Lightning speed kicks.
Oh!
Right there. Swift boot to the side of the earlobe.
And right to that top rope to get the crowd approval. Now, Holy Twin Acid will need metal rods in that knee after that fucking drop kick. One drop kick by Nizawa can end your fucking career, 3D.
What style do you want to take to Nizawa? He's done it before. He's mastered all styles. Do you want to bring a lucha style? Do you want to bring a Japan style?
Or a fucking Roddy Piper eye poke style? There it goes.
He's got them all down, and he's ready for battle. Hard ass and shoulder tackle. Lightning speed over him once again. Under the legs. And...
oh, oh, oh!
Right there. Super kick to the chin of the asshole.
There you go. He's lucky he didn't kick him in the asshole with that kick.
Shades of...
his asshole would have been hanging out the end of his dick hole.
Shades of Great Muta once again, we're seeing his mentor shining through Nozawa.
Of course you are, because Nozawa is Muta's star pupil. And look at him. He's going to throw him into the turnbuckles and finish him off right. Oh, what is this dastardly deeds? This motherfucker, you know what? Ooh. Oh, he gave him a taste of his own medicine and made fun out of him on top of it. What a fucking cocksucker. Let me tell you something about this guy, Trent Acid. I don't like him. Straight up, I don't like him. I'm not a heel, I'm a face, and I'm not a fan of this fucking guy humping men.
Well, not many people do like him, Guido, but he is no joke in a squared circle, and his win-loss record cannot be disputed, and his talents cannot be denied.
You're right, it can't be denied, it can't be disputed, but nonetheless, I think you like his humping techniques, and I don't like you for liking him. Look at this shit right here. He's standing up on the rope. Even JCW has standards of cheating, Greedy. And right there is blatant fucking choking on that bottom rope. And I'm getting bloody fucking pissed off about this shit.
Fucking chill your balls off. Because I'm confident Nozawa will handle this problem by bell's end.
I don't know what the fuck bell's end are.
Bell's God end means by the time the motherfucking bell rings.
Well, good. Bell's end. Ball's end. Balls hanging. All I know is Trent Acid is letting his balls hang in Nozawa's face right now, and I'm not digging what the fuck I'm seeing. I know he's used to little boys, but this is a fucking grown man, Derek. And look at that. Blatant disrespect by grabbing him up, picking him up, slamming him down, and what the fuck? He's blessing him. Notice, he don't need blessing. He's a Buddhism.
Notice how Trent Acid likes to bless his opponents. Only you got to notice, Nozawa is always aware of his positioning.
Holy ever!
Trent Acid was just blessed face first by the canvas.
You're fucking right. And you are right. Nozawa knows his way around that ring, and he knew Trent Acid was coming onto the canvas, and he fucking moved just in time for Trent Acid.
There it is! The Shining Wizard right there. Talk to him by the one and only Great Muta.
This might be it right here, 3D. I think we're talking 1, 2, 3. But Nozawa's stalling. He's not doing the pin. He's not picking the leg up. Oh, but he ducks.
He's very rarely do you see Nozawa make those kind of mistakes.
Let me tell you
very rarely do you see Nozawa be overtaken by the Juggalo audience and actually slip and not go for a pin like that.
But, 3D, right now, Trent Acid is at the disadvantage. He's outside the ring. Outside the ring is 10 times more deadly than inside the ring.
Have a
Look
seat.
At that. Oh, shit. Have a seat. A hot steamer on your face. That outside the ring right there is full of debris. It's full of garbage. It's full of metal chunks. It's full of auto car parts. It doesn't matter what the fuck goes down. Shit is going down outside the ring where the rules are out the fucking window. And look it. He's bringing outside of the ring to the inside of the ring. Nozawa is not fucking playing. He's bringing these JCW rules to his advantage inside the ring as well as outside the ring.
The capacity crowd, without a doubt, behind their hero Nozawa. But once again, Trent Acid could give a fuck less about the people, only concerned about dirty tactics and whatever it's going to take to pin this man to the mat.
With the Hurricane Crossface DDT. 1, 2, go!
No good.
3D, you could have been more right. I think Nozawa could have pinned him 2 or 3 times more. But he's concerned with the Juggalo chance and the Juggalo approval. As to where Trent Acid don't give a fuck about that. He's carrying on his ruthless assault left and right. But yet he has not won for a pin himself.
Trent Acid, having competed all over the North Coast, all over the East Coast, all over the Northeast, and the Eastern North Coast.
Well, 3D, the North Coast would be the fucking Antarctic, up there on the North Pole where Santa Claus lives. And I think maybe he started a missionary up there and had all the elves gathered around him and pedophile him. But that does not matter right now. Right now, Nozawa is face down on that chair, ready for his chin to go. Oh!
Once again, Nozawa, no stranger, very aware of where his opponent is at all time, kicks the top rope, causing Trent to fall and split his pussy wide open on that steel rack.
And that now goes back to that ring experience with the superplex to add insult to injury through the motherfucking chair.
Awesome.
Holy shit.
Going for the pin.
1, 2. Oh! See, right there, Trent Acid, not giving a fuck about crowd approval. That is why he kicked off. The only reason, and on top of that, the Zawa did not hook the fucking leg. If he would have hooked that leg, he would have had it. I believe so. You believe so.
I believe the referee's arms were too long and lanky, causing too much time before the hand slapped on the mat. And it was a slow count.
It didn't stop that long leg from kicking him in the fucking... Oh!
Oh!
And what is
get
that?
Out of the way!
Oh!
Right there.
2, 3, oh!
Damn it!
I believe that damn Holy it. Bible is a satanic Bible with the Holy Bible cover on it. There's no way a Holy Bible would have done that. But we must remember that the Japanese Juggalo Cessation is a Buddhist.
I can't believe it. Holy Trent!
And all of you say that?
Asshole!
It's holy shit, Trent.
He used the good book for an evil purpose, and he gained the victory.
You know, 3D? Oh, there it goes, right there. Dragon kick. Maybe it should be called the bad book. I don't know what to think. My brain is turned into mush. Oatmeal, if you will. Perhaps grits with extra butter and sugar.
It was a great match. There it is, Lucifer's Loop. It looked bad for Nozawa. And there, superplex onto the chair. It looked good for Nozawa. But you know what? Asshole Trent Acid could not pin Nozawa until he used foul tactics. In wrestling alone, Guido, in wrestling alone, Trent Acid could not defeat Nozawa.
No, he couldn't.
He needed to use the crooked good book for evil purposes. Thus, he gained the victory. Bullshit, I say.
Bro.
Bullshit.
What I say is fuck holy.
Hey, Trent.
Yeah, I got this camera, dude. Hold on. I think I got this promo. I'll call you back. All right.
What's up, man?
Trent, I'm sorry to bug you. I've been trying to catch up to you. I want to get your thoughts on facing Sabu at Pro Wrestling Syndicate.
Sabu? You say Sabu, I'm supposed to be scared, right?
Homicidal, genocidal, suicidal, death-defying athlete.
Right? It's a dude that points to the air and there's nothing friggin' there.
You know,
I'd be a liar if I told you what I've seen with Sabu hasn't impressed me. Because it has. This guy's wrestled everyone in the world and has beat most of them. But you see, it's 2007. Trent Acid's 26 years old. He's in the prime of his career. I've had much success everywhere I went. They call me the international superstar. Sabu, this ain't 1996, and I'm not sitting in the crowd this time. This time I'm on the other side of the barricade. And when you're pointing to the sky, the only thing in the sky you're going to be seeing are the lights. Because T-Acid is coming into Jersey, it's taking you out.
This Danny character in the ring?
Who's this guy?
What do you mean you don't know who Danny Doring is?
Listen, I'm from New York City. I'm on the radio every day. I'm a hobnobber with Kanye West and 50 Cent. I don't have time to have a Danny Doring. What's the guy's name?
I don't know what to say to you, Peter Rosenberg.
I just honestly... Wow. Sabu has entered the building in Garfield, New Jersey, to a lot of love.
I suck knives. I'm the only sober person in the match. online, pal. And slap where everybody's going. Let's go for it.
Hey, do one slap it.
My friend.
Hey, don't forget, Sabu has been on the biggest stage imaginable in this business.
We got about 800 years left before you check out. So why don't you both do me a favor, call this our chest and both choose back. I'll tell you what, no hard card match right here, you know what? That's the problem with wrestling these days, you people, and God help me.
Sabu, who's just, you know, been around the business, back and forth. You know, he's been to the top of the mountain.
I mean, absolutely, what a... Whoa! Big red clothesline from Danny Doring. I have a cover from Trent Acid, one, two.
Hey, I got news for you, okay?
Yes, sir.
I've seen Sabu give a 500-pound, 7-foot giant a run for his money. You think there's a chance this guy's going to lose to Trent Acid? With all due respect, to Trent Acid or Danny Doring?
You know, I'll be honest, I'm really surprised you're throwing your support behind Sabu. You seem like the kind of person... What?
Okay, so we are seeing Just Incredible tonight. We are seeing Just Incredible tonight. And to speak to your point moments ago, you know what? I have to respect Sabu.
It's all right, you have Danny Doring, Just Incredible, and Sabu, all from ECW, all of this one match.
This is what people pay to see. This one, you cannot complain about two legends being in the ring together. That's the bottom line. You can say whatever you want about Sabu. The guy has proven himself, and there he goes with the chair. And this is what you have to respect. Because if you don't respect Sabu, he's going to make you pay. I guarantee it.
Very true.
Got that chair in the ring right now. I guarantee this doesn't work that well for Just Incredible.
Oh, wait a minute. Just Incredible stopped him. Oh, maybe not.
See, he's a crafty old man, that Sabu.
Just faced him.
Oh, hold on. What's Sabu on the chair again?
Oh, wait a minute. Lost his balance.
He's going to do it again, though.
He's going to go for it again.
He's going to do it again this time.
Goes!
Does it miss the second time?
That's why it's called high risk maneuvers, Peter Rosenberg.
Hey, listen.
Maybe if you got him off your ass out of the DJ booth every once in a while.
Listen, I'll say this about this Sabu.
Sabu just left. I heard Sabu say, well, forget them. And he just left. Whoa,
wait a minute. Oh, hold on. Hold the phone. Sabu is back.
But he's not back by himself.
No, he's not in a table this time. A huge, that's about 12-foot table.
Wait a minute. I can't really see from my vantage point. All the crowd standing on their feet. I think I saw Trent Acid go for a Yakuza on Just Incredible.
You know, this is the action the fans paid for tonight when they decided to come set foot in the trashiest town in the Northeast.
The match that was crossed.
Look at you.
Across the admission alone.
What a mark you are. Up on your chair. Hold on, Trent Acid.
I can't see the call. Oh! Trent Acid pulled off his head first right into the ring apron.
The second I see Sabu get a table, I know someone's in serious, serious trouble. And that person is probably not Sabu. And here he goes.
Oh!
And over.
And I heard a solid thud when he hit that table.
Hold on.
You know, it's hard to see from here exactly what happened. I saw a fan say he hit his head against the table.
Hold on, it appears to me from here that Sabu left off the ropes like he had so many times in ECW and WWE, only did not break the table but landed on the table.
Well, regardless of how he hit, the crowd here firmly behind Sabu.
And is Sabu still fighting his way out? He could have been seriously injured.
Oh, there he is.
There he's back to the ring. Oh, up again. It's a guarantee Sabu ain't messing that up twice. You know what, is Sabu 65, 70 years old?
Hey, now come on.
Just saying, the guy's been in the business for a long time. I respect him, and he's getting up there.
Sabu going for another one, two, but there's Danny Doran. We haven't seen him in this match in a while.
There's Danny Doran, ruining all the fun, like I said, for the jump.
Danny was recovering on the outside. Now taking advantage of the situation, this is no DQ matchup.
Listen, Grandpa Sabu, odds have to favor this guy. He's still holding on to that head, though, which apparently landed flush on the table.
You see Trent Acid, the international superstar, rallying up the crowd here. Wait a minute, how Danny Doran caught him. Dragging him out. What's he going to do? Oh! Right there. Dragged off the top row. One, two. Oh, they got a two count. Justin Credible broke up the count. Now Justin Credible's in super kick. Laying out Doran. Oh, that's Credible. Oh, here it comes. And you know what? That's incredible. Oh, two count. Holding up by that chain.
Well, apparently now, the table that I thought, oh, Sabu goes off the top rope with a chair, apparently the table is not broken.
Three!
It doesn't matter, though, when Sabu lands with a chair off the top rope, I guarantee you, you're not getting up.
Yeah.
competitors eyeing up each other, trying to figure out who's who in this competition. Who's most dangerous and who to get rid of first. Who to focus their attention at. Who's going to walk away the victor in this four-way dance? Monster Mac, Xavier, the new horror Sami Callihan, and the international superstar Trent Acid. Acid trying to get the crowd into this matchup right here in Garfield, New Jersey. Trying to build up some momentum, some energy. There you go. Brawls on both sides of the ring. Xavier, Trent Acid going back and forth. Sami Callihan, Monster Mac going back and forth. Trent has Xavier back in that corner, just trying to choke out Xavier. And Callihan already grounded, now being choked out by Monster Mac. But Xavier now has Trent Acid. Nice little shot. Nice little jib to the face. Wait a minute. Oh, knockout from the clothesline. Sami Callihan in control. The Monster Mac coming off the ropes. Oh, but caught. Caught. But Monster Mac lost his footing. Both men go down. Trent Acid now down from Xavier. Xavier has both hands now picking up Trent Acid, but Acid still trying to fight Xavier off. Kenny Kaplan's, oh no, there you go, trading partners, getting rid of Monster Mac, the big man. Smart one to focus your attention on. Get rid of the big man first if you can. And now it's just one-on-one in the ring between Trent Acid and Xavier. Xavier Wizard, Trent Acid, Xavier going back and forth, reversals. Trent Acid comes in, oh, wait a minute, duck under by Xavier. Trent Acid almost sent flying to the floor. Oh, wait a minute, Trent catches Xavier, no. No, 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 are we going to see? No. Xavier able to maneuver his way out, caught on the apron. Oh, 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 come, ref, oh, yeah, ref, oh, yeah, don't worry. He just kicked him in the thigh or something. Trent Acid DDT to Xavier on the apron of the ring. All four competitors now on the outside of the ring. Oh, split kick from Monster Mac on Sami Callihan. Rich Bass starting to count. You don't want to count out in this matchup. This is a great matchup. Four-way dance between four tremendous competitors. Somebody needs to get back in the ring. Sami Callihan tossed back in the ring by Monster Mac. Oh, nice shot from Monster Mac. Callihan up to his feet. Uh-oh. I thought he was going to go for a dive, but sees Trent Acid, kicks him up. Here he comes. Off the ropes. Oh, dive! Corkscrew planted to the outside, or I should say corkscrew suicide dive to the outside by the new horror, Sami Callihan. Now with a handful of hair, as Trent Acid up, tosses him in the ring. Monster Mac down on the outside. Haven't really seen much right now from Xavier lately, though. There he goes, back up to his feet. Those two going at it on the outside. Callihan, solid right hand. Imagine the mush of Trent Acid. Could we see a superplex from the top? Limit Trent Acid. Trent Acid has his feet locked. Callihan trying to power up Trent Acid. But Acid now fighting Callihan. Uh-oh. No! I thought we were going to see Sunset Flip from the top. Callihan fighting off Trent Acid. Whoa! Now that's a right hand. Wait a minute. We can see it already. Right from the top! Oh! Callihan dropped right on his face. One, two, go! No, Xavier right in there, able to save Callihan from that three count. Xavier, quick elbow right to the face. Now running! Powerful drive. Trent Acid just crushed in that corner. Monster Mac pushing off Xavier. Uh-oh. Oh, here comes Mac. Here comes Mac! All the weight of Mac just planted across the face of Trent Acid. Now he's going for a cover. Hook the leg, one, two, oh, but Callihan breaking up the count this time. There can only be one winner in this matchup. Callihan trying to make sure it's going to be him. Trying to go for a chop and a headbutt, but you know, not the smartest thing to do against a guy like Monster Mac. Oh, and he'll make you feel it in the morning. Uh-oh, Callihan, forearm to the face. No, oh, wait a minute, blocked. Oh, Monster Mac rocking Callihan. Oh, there you go, swift kick. Callihan winding up Monster Mac, reversal. Oh, Callihan throwing hard. Oh, the kick got his leg up. Oh, big club, no, got caught. Callahan was going to run in for his famous lariat, but instead, Monster Mac catches him. Wait a minute. Mac's going up top. Up to the very top, the top turnbuckle. Off comes Mac. Big splash, Callahan. Callahan, he might be broken. Only a two count. Xavier on his way in, stopping the count. Reference Bass right in there, calling the action. Oh, Monster Mac. Again, shots to the face. Now back and forth between these two men. Xavier coming off. Oh, he catches the foot of Monster Mac, tosses it down. Ducks her into the clothesline. Oh, big chop. Looking up. Oh, we cannot see this. Oh, my God. What power from Xavier. I can't believe he just muscled him up. Oh, Callahan. Big lariat right to the back of the head. Yakuza. Yakuza on the face of Sammy Callahan. But now covering him. Monster Mac. 1, 2, 3. The international superstar Trent Acid, able to pull off a victory right here tonight at Pro Wrestling Syndicate. Trent Acid wins the four-way dance. I can't believe, I can't even say he stole the victory. It was a good win. Trent Acid, with his hand raised high, able to pull off a victory here tonight at the Brawl for Call in this four-way.
Congratulations, you're the first CZW superstar entered in best of the best three.
That's right. That I am. Best of the best.
And you are the defending best of the best champion.
That I am too. I'm the man. Hey, yo. I'm the best of the best champion. I got nothing else to prove. Bring them. Japan, Germany, where else? Amsterdam, east, north, south, west, wherever the hell you're from. Come on down to where my home is in CZW.
Of course.
And the best of the best.
And ladies and gentlemen, best of the best three is shaping up to be the biggest CZW event of the season. Get your tickets now for Saturday night, April the 12th.
And we're about to get underway in this three-way contest. Again, three tremendous competitors in Alex Shelley, Trent Acid, and the Human Tornado.
And there's the bell.
And there goes the crowd. The crowd is ready. They want to see some great wrestling action here. And I think they're about to get their fill with this three-way dance. Puma Tornado calling for a test of strength. Looks like he's going to ask Alex Shelley. Wait a minute. Alex Shelley for it.
It's going to be three ways here. Do these guys know the left from the right or the what?
Oh, wait a minute. It's Human Tornado. He's just getting down and getting ready. What's he doing here? What was that?
Ah.
The Human Tornado just made the human wave, and now he's being pounded on by Alex Shelley and Trent Acid. Oh, and Oisik Shelley just pushing Trent Acid. Trent Acid pushing back, goes for right, blocks it, now headlock. Shelley pushing off Trent Acid off the ropes. Oh, big shoulder tackle. Acid's off the rope once again. A cartwheel over. Oh, Alex Shelley attempted hip toss block. Trent Acid up and over. And a Human Tornado springboard! Beautiful springboard double drop kick. Trudeau has Shelley. Shelley comes off the ropes. Oh, beautiful leapfrog by Human Tornado. Oh, down goes Tornado. Leg lariat sends Shelley flying to the outside.
Come on, Tornado!
Acid
taunting.
He wants to hear this crowd now. Oh, oh! He just got a response, but I don't know if that's how we wanted it. Now Tornado sending off Acid reverses. Tornado in the corner. We've been faking up and over. Oh, oh! Cross body. Acid back up. Tornado sends Acid into the corner. Acid is up. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, he was trying to play some mind games, but Tornado saw it coming. Look at the heels. That's him outside now with the clothesline. Wait a minute, but Shelley. From behind, he's going up top.
Here it comes.
Shelley's pushed up, and Tornado sees him.
Come on, guys, go.
This doesn't look good for Shelley.
Oh, Shelley just biting.
Beautiful move.
Oh, come on.
Beautiful move.
How can you say that? Ooh, Tornado's down. Shelley up top. Oh, he's coming up. Oh, knee. A flying knee right to the side of the head. Now it's Shelley in control. Trent Acid somewhere on the outside. He wants Tornado being picked up, back up on his feet. Shelley has him up. Oh, kick right to the ribs. Up comes Shelley, but Trent Acid trips him.
Fantastic. Oh.
Melee on the outside, but Tornado.
Unbelievable.
Tornado up and over.
High risk move. We'll see if it pays off. You know, far be it for me to flip-flop, but I've decided I'm not a big fan of the Human Tornado. I think he's too cool for school. I don't really like his attitude. I'm going to go with Trent Acid.
Fair enough, I guess. Human Tornado, definitely a tremendous competitor. Now has the international superstar Trent Acid in the ring. Picking Trent Acid back up, backing him up into the corner. Oh, chopping him down. Goes to send Acid off. Acid blocks it, though. Oh! One leg mule kick.
That looked low.
Oh! Beautiful spinning neck breaker right out of the corner. You might be right, Trance. It just might pull this off. Oh, but in comes Alex Shelley. Oh, just kicking away at Trent Acid.
Your whole game plan needs to change when you're in there with two other men as opposed to just one.
Oh! Beautiful move from Trent Acid. Going for cover. One, two. But only gets a two count. Very close. Trask just measuring Alex Shelley with that right hand. Send him off into the corner. Shelley reverses Trent Acid. In comes Shelley. Oh, beautiful back elbow. I think Shelley going to the outside. Oh!
That had to hurt.
Needs a gear with some leverage from the ropes. Comes off. Beautiful one-leg drop kick. What is this?
He's on fire.
Shelley just might be showing off a little bit too much. Like you said, he's in there with two other guys. He can't let his guard down. All right now this choking Human Tornado out over in the corner. You know, some actions I know you would condone.
As a matter of fact, I would. Win if you can, try if you must, but yeah, always cheat.
I guess some wise advice from the manager of champions himself, Mr. Sean Gorman, is Human Tornado sent flying to the opposite corner. Oh!
drop toe. Oh, Shelly goes face first right into that middle turnbuckle. Uh-oh, we've seen this. Some shucking, some jiving, and some kicks right to the face.
This is what I'm talking about. I don't like this attitude. He's dead to me. He's dead to me.
Just picking away, and hear the crowd. The crowd's into it. They want to see him come.
Uncalled for.
Now you're right. I think you're right before it. There is some style for you. Oh! Tornado just knocked Acid off to the outside. Has Shelly all had a front chancery. But Shelly, oh! Just jacked his jaw. Now comes off. Oh, standing Inzaghi. Or running Inzaghi, rather. Armier locking him up. Oh, rolling him up with a clutch. One, two, oh!
What a move. What a move.
Of course, Alex Shelley, definitely a tremendous technical wrestler in the ring. You know, he doesn't need to resort to some of the cheap tactics that we've seen him do here tonight. And now Trent Acid's in control, and looks like he's going to go up top. It comes here with Tornado, though.
And as I said, when it's another man in the ring, this is what you have to be aware of. If it was just the two of them, he would have pulled off that move.
Now Shelley now, setting up Human Tornado. Up in that top rope, what's he going to do with him? Locking him up for something. I think he was going to set him up for a German. Oh, is it Trent Acid's up? What's Trent doing?
This doesn't bode well.
Reverse Rana! And Tornado just jerked him right on the back of
Trent
Acid.
My goodness.
Shelly all tied up on the ropes there. Been amazing so far. And what a great way to start off Pro Wrestling Syndicate right here in Garfield, New Jersey. Trent goes for a right hand. Shelly ducks. Oh, Trent Acid able to land on his feet. Oh, wait a minute. Trent Acid was caught. Now Human Tornado has control. Trent Acid. Oh, but Trent Acid reverses. Setting up. Now Shelly just pounded away at Acid's back. Three-way headlock. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, double back suplex.
I'm not sure who got the best of that, but it looks like Shelly came out okay.
Not too sure. He's reeling a little bit too. But it looks like he will be possibly the first man back on his feet. And it is. Shelly's up first. Swift kick to the ribs of the Human Tornado. Oh, come on. He doesn't need to do this. Just stepping on the throat of Human Tornado.
Fantastic. He gives you confidence.
Oh, swift kick to the back of Trent Acid. He's trying to make sure he knows where his two opponents are at all times. Oh, wait a minute. Human Tornado reverses Alex Shelly. Crisscross back and forth across the ring. Why, what would you even call that?
Not sure he got all of that he wanted, but it looked effective.
That running corkscrew. Able to connect cover. Only gets a two count, though. Shelly saying no. Human Tornado's back up on his feet. Now pounds away at Trent Acid. Wants to make sure that he stays in control. Very wise move. Picks up big slam from Human Tornado. Oh, wait a minute. Human Tornado, he's calling for it. He's going to go up top.
This is it. This could be it.
He needs to watch out. I see Shelly. Shelly's back up. And he looks a little dazed. Human Tornado. Oh!
My goodness.
Catches him flying into a flying H crusher. Now super kick. Where's he going? Oh! Catches him. Oh, but Trent Acid comes in with the Yakuza. Misses. Oh, connects with that one. Goes for cover. One, two, three.
Wow.
Hey, can I pick a winner? Can I pick a winner? He had to change it, though.
Hey. Fantastic.
Unbelievable victory for the international superstar, Trent Acid, here for PWS Pro Wrestling Syndicate in our debut showing in Garfield, New Jersey.